Okay, we're going to go for a slightly variation of a design in our sleeve. The one that I've decided to go for, these are called sheared sleeves, and basically what we're going to do is we're going to go for the sheared string sheared effect of the sleeve. For this, basically we need the string, which I'll go on to teach you how to make. But the first part of this is obviously the sleeve length is quite considerably long. We will need to create the sheared look in this sleeve. So up to the point of the elbow, which is going to be approximately 12 inches, is a normal sleeve. So the first part of the sleeve is a normal sleeve. The cut on the upper portion is just a normal cut that you would cut for your own size. So you could use your template or your camise as your guideline for cutting the upper portion. You don't want it overly wide. It needs to be a slightly fitted look. Now the bottom half of this up to here is going to be just like a normal normal camise. And then from here onwards, it's going to have to form the gathers to form a sheared effect look. So what we're going to do is decide on the width of our sleeve. I would make this approximately 5 inches and meet that 5 inches with my portion of where I'm going to be stringing this to. Now there's two advice parts that I would offer here. Now Halima is very, very broad shouldered, and it's very hard to sew for her because the cup of her sleeve always tends to pull. I've experimented with lots of different variations, and I think what I need to do with her is give her more of a cup portion to the sleeve compared to an average other person's cutting. So the depth of her cup, I'm going to do a slightly larger, because this is something that I've noticed with her, that when she wears the clothes, when she wears a camise, it tends to pull in quite a lot because she is very, very broad shouldered. It tends to pull on the sleeve quite a lot. So in trying to find a remedy for that, that would be my try and find that solution and see if that works. Now the recommendation that I was actually, suggestions that I was making was that where you are going to be shearing this, you need to pre-mark this, and the best form of pre-marking is, at the moment my fabric is pinned, both my sleeves are pinned together, and where I'm going to, this is a double sort of on the spot double sort of shearing that's been done, and that's the kind of shearing effect that I want to do. So if I wanted to shear it up to here, I'm going to fold this in half, if I'm going to shear it along up to this point, then I'm going to fold this over and press this that into place. Also, where I'm going to be adding the pieces for the shearing, which is roughly about here, I will fold this over and again crease mark all this line, so that when I'm attaching the piece that I will be inserting the string through, I know exactly where I will be attaching that. So I will leave that pinned. The other parts that I needed out of this is my spare fabric, and two of the other parts that I needed was the belt for the silhouette. This was 3 yards of fabric that I used. Now Halima is quite slim, so we can take out the belt. We could take it out the opposite way, but I tend to prefer going in the one direction. And so here, even your fabric off. And mark off the length of the belt. That's the belt. Also, I'm going to cut two pieces to go underneath the poncho. Also, the piece of fabric that I need to cut for the back of the neckline. And very, very important pieces that I need, which I don't think I've got enough fabric in this to be cutting these out of, is my strings that I will be using for the shearing. And in actual fact, there is a slight bit of a mistake that I made because I didn't decide on the type of sleeve that I was going to do. This is something that I missed out on, but what I'm going to do now is I'm going to cut these pieces in an angled manner, and hopefully once I'll attach these together, once I've turned them over, most of this will get hidden inside the sheared effect of the sleeve. So in total, I think I'm going to need about 6 pieces. I could have done with this one longer piece, but it doesn't matter. So that is going to be my sheared sleeve, and I think that concludes all the pieces that I require. And I don't think I'm going to get fabric left to make Now I've just got to decide on the neckline. Now because the sleeves are sheared, I'd like to do some kind of a sheared effect neckline to this. I'm going to work along on some idea of what I decide to do with this. Okay, I'm going to work along on some ideas for the neckline, because ideally I'd like to do a type of sheared effect neckline, but how I'm going to sort of balance that out, I'm not very sure. So once I've got some kind of an idea formed in my head, I'm going to work on that and hopefully guide you on that.